Assalamu alaikum and welcome to all of you. This lecture is about writing skills. After this presentation and activities, a learner should be able to know about writing skills, define the narrative skills, list the salient features of descriptive writing, define the term expository or expository skills, and then write well-organized paragraphs and essays or write-ups at the end of this lecture as a result of this lecture. First of all, the writing process. A writer must keep in mind the following measures, the following steps before writing a project, an assignment, or a presentation. First of all, analyze the topic. What is the topic or what is the assignment which has been given to a writer to write about that topic? Then brainstorm, this is the second step. Then plan your time. Time management is very, very important. So the writers, they should plan their time or manage their time for the accomplishment of a project. Then next step is construct a rough plan. Start your preliminary research. Start writing. Make several drafts. Then at the end, proofreading of the final draft, and after proofreading, then the writer, he or she should submit his project or her project which has been written about assignments and presentation. Then the next point is writing effectively. For writing effectively, a writer, he or she must know his or her purpose, why he or she is writing a piece of writing, a paragraph, an essay, a report, an assignment, etc., etc. Analyze the audience. This step is actually about the readers. So when a writer, when he or she writes a project, a report, a situation, or an essay, he or she must keep in mind the mental level of the readers or the audience, and then presentation of ideas in written form. For that, the ideas, they should be selected. Then about those ideas or thoughts, the facts should be collected, the relevant facts should be collected about that project, about that write-up. Then at the end, organize your message in written form. So the write-up, the report, the essay, a paragraph, then it should be presented in a proper manner. What is writing or what is writing skill? So writing is the interaction of mind and word. Or writing is a skill which a learner learns in stages. Then we can also say that writing and speech, they are the outward reflections of thought. What is in our mind or in thought, when we are writing, when we are speaking, actually that speech or that write-up, it is actually the reflection of our thoughts, our ideas, or what is in our mind. Then writing prompts. If you want to start promptly, abruptly, at once, so as a starting point, you should write that I would like to explain why I think that. This is a good beginning, so you should learn it. These steps are these points. It should be at your fingertips whenever you want to write promptly or abruptly or at once. You can also beginning your write-up as "in my opinion," and then you should put all the details about it. Or when you want to mention some specific points, you can say there are 3 or 4 or 5 basic reasons why I think I should write about them. This is actually continue with writing prompts. When you want to give the details about a situation, about a report, so you can write an example of this is, "This may sound rather confusing, let me explain." Accepting an idea but not convinced, then in that case you can write that, "These all are important points. These points are very, very vital. However, I would like to add that." So then here you can write, you can add your ideas, your thoughts. "So I don't find that a very convincing argument, so I would like to add that." This is another point which you can write. If you want to add a new point, so you can write, "In addition to, we have to think about," or you can write, "An important difference to make is," or "compared with." So these are for adding a new point when you want just to begin promptly. Ending. So all in all, we can say, "In conclusion, I feel that," so "my main point is that," or you can write, "to conclude that." Then we will come to the sub skills of writing. So writing sub skills. Writing sub skills can be narration or narrative, description or descriptive skills, and expository skills. In narration we have story, events, autobiography. In description we can describe the people, places and objects. And expository writing is about definition, classification, analogy, cause and effect, compare and contrast, etc., etc. So first, what is narration, or what are narrative skills? The narration of a series of linked events, the narration of a story. Narration usually occur in the past, so we can write the past events. In fact, this can be accommodated in the narrative skills or in the narrative writing. So narrative writing, there are two things which are very important, that is story and plot. First of all, what is a story? A story is a narrative of events arranged in proper time sequence. Just like we can say, "Once upon a time there was," so this is a narration. As an example, we can say, "The king died and then the queen died." This is in fact a story. In a story we always use the word "then," or we can say that what happened next. So we can say "then and then and then and then." As far as the plot is concerned, so plot tells us about the cause of the events or why something happens or occurs. Just an example, we can say that the king died and the queen died of grief. So in first example, the king died and the queen died, this is a story, because the first one happening and then the second in proper sequence. The king died, and after the death of the king, then the queen died. So These are two events which occurred one after the other. As far as the king died and the queen died of grief, so here this tells us about the cause of the death of the queen. The reason is given as the grief. So the grief is the cause, so this is the plot. Then sequence of events. All events follow each other. Either event A happens before event B or it happens after it. When we write an account of these events, we have to show this sequential relationship by using words which express time relationships. Here are a few examples of such words. Just like we can say first, then we can also say before, then, next, during, after, while, subsequently, finally, eventually, and so on. Then sequence of events, this is continued with the first slide. So last night there was a bomb blast in the fruit market. The bomb exploded at 4 a.m. as this was a busy time in the market. A large number of people were hurt. This is one example of the sequence of events. If you look at it, so this is a series of events. So the explosion of the bomb, then the time is given, and then the casualties and the peak time, and this is all these events, they are put in a proper sequence. There is another example, which is we reached London in the morning. It was cold and gray, but it didn't matter. We were met at the airport by our friends. First they took us home, where we had a light breakfast and had a shower afterwards. And I couldn't sleep, so here you can continue your sequence of events and you can add the rest of the details. Now there is an activity for you. Write a short paragraph using the words first, before, then, next, during, after, while, subsequently, finally, or eventually. So you should accommodate these words in your write-up, in your narrative, and definitely that will be a very good example, a good piece of narrative skills. Again, there is another activity for you. This is about the sentences which have been written over here in the activity. There are four sentences, and these sentences, they are not in proper order. So what is your responsibility or your activity here? You should rearrange these sentences in proper sequence, and that will be an example of a narrative skill or narration or sequence of events. Another example, this is about a shopkeeper of a certain locality. So it consists of several paragraphs. Here the introduction is given of the narration or the narrative passage. The points are given. Then you can write an introduction with the help of these points. Then the second paragraph of the narrative passage, the details, some points, they are given over here. In the light of these points, you should write the second paragraph of the narrative passage. Then third paragraph, this is again about certain other events are sequence of events. They are given over here. You should put these details, these points, accommodate these points in paragraph number 3 and then paragraph number 4, 5 and at last the conclusion. This is an activity for you, and at the end then you will accommodate all these points or parts, just like introduction, then para 2, para 3, 4, 5. After putting the details in sequence and writing the conclusion, you will get a good piece of write-up, and that will be a nice example of a logical example of a narrative skill. Then second sub-skill is description or descriptive writing. Through description we can describe people we know, places we visit and things we buy or possess. Quite often our descriptions are highly subjective. Our choices of adjectives make clear to the reader our attitudes toward the things we are describing. Through description we can describe people we know, places we visit and things we buy or possess, and then we can write about, we can describe those places, we can describe those objects and those personalities which we meet in our daily life, or about the appearances, about the places which we visit. So in description we have to make a picture for the imagination of the readers with the help of words. So it depends on your word power, your range of vocabulary, and particularly specific vocabulary. If you have specific vocabulary, then you can make your descriptions very, very charming and attractive. The descriptive writing or descriptive skills can be classified into subjective and objective. Subjective description is when we include our feelings, our sentiments, our emotions in a piece, and when we describe the personalities, the people, the places, the objects in the light of our likes and dislikes, our emotions, then definitely that is a subjective description. And objective descriptions, this is without the inclusion, without adding our feelings, our likes and dislikes, and definitely that is very, very important for the journalists and for the other writers who want to write the reports, the projects, the assignments, without including their feelings, their sentiments. So such type of description, they are called objective descriptions. Specific details should be added for good descriptions, and then we should provide specific details. General comments produce a hazy picture. If the students of a class merely say that their English tutor is good, it doesn't tell the reader much. But if they say that he or she is punctual, regular, that he always returns their tests and assignments promptly, then that means something different, and that specific detail, they can provide a clear picture of the thing. Through descriptive skills, we can write about a person's appearance, physique, and personality. Here is just a stanza taken from the well-known poem by John Keats, that is La Belle Dame Sans Merci. I met a lady in the midst, full, beautiful, a fairy's child. Her hair was long, her foot was light, and her eyes were wild. So that lady, her appearance, it is described, this is also called imagery, and John Keats, in with the help of his imagery, then he has told us about the appearance of that lady. Similarly, E.M. Forster, in his book The Hill of Devi, which is a travelogue, he says that in a fortnight the monsoon ought to break, then all will be cooler and damps too, and the roads will be dotted with tortoises and frogs. So actually this is description, the roads will be dotted with tortoises and frogs. It means that on roads, after the heavy rain, the frogs and the tortoises, they will come out, they will be on the roads, and they will be visible from a distance as dots on the road. So this is also a very good example of imagery or a descriptive skill. Now again, there is an activity for you. A friend has given you an object as a present, but you don't like it. So describe it to another friend why you don't like it. Now again, you will have to put the details of that gift and the specific information given to your friend why you don't like it. Next is expository writing. And through expository writing, we define, classify, compare and contrast, or with the help of examples, exemplification and classification, we can provide the details. So in expository writing, a point is explained, exemplified or justified or argumented. Now the example is, first of all is analogy. Analogy is in fact a figure of speech that compares two things or makes them equivalent. Similarity drawn is only superficial, the two items belong to very different classes. Just like the human heart is like a pump, or their life is the story of Romeo and Juliet. So this is, here in these two examples, they represent the analogy, and analogy, the two things they are compared, but in fact the mode of comparison is not the same as simile or as another figure of speech. Cause and effect. Cause and effect reasoning is often a simple connecting of two events. Such assumptions are sometimes left unstated because writers accept them as given, just like heat expands matter. Many plants were affected by the same disease. In anticipation of the budget, prices rose. Because it is the dry season, several homes are without water. So, cause and effect, this expository writing sub-skill is not so simple. and the cause and effect can be explained as X causes Y. This is a direct relationship. So or we can say X therefore Y. X happens because of Y. X so Y. X results in Y. X consequently Y or X owing to Y. X happens for this reason. This is about cause and effect, comparison and contrast. Compare and contrast means similarities and differences and their accommodation in the writing skills. Similarities and differences are often noted when we are classifying the things. The language of comparison and contrast is frequently needed when studying tables and statistical information or statistical data. Then definition. Definition is in fact a method of explaining what things are, and as such it follows a fairly set formulaic pattern. So a pen is an instrument used for writing. This is in fact a definition of an instrument which is called a pen. A university is a place like Peshawar University. Here this is not so clear. However, you can say Peshawar University is a place for learning higher education or higher studies. Providing examples with definition. This is an activity which is based on definitions. So match the following definitions. There are two columns. One is here in your first slide and the other is given at the second slide, and we have classified the columns as A and B. So what you will have to do, you will select a definition from here, just like an engineer is a person who, what that person does, that is given over here in column B. You will have to match column A with column B, and in this way you can get a definition of about a person, about an instrument, or about a book. Then another example of expository writing is argument. Here in argument we can give the details, we can provide the details in for and against form or in a continuous paragraph form. It depends on the style of the writer or the speaker, how he or she can put the details about the specific occasion or specific piece of writing or specific point. So sometimes we have to provide our arguments in various for and against form, or we can write a continuous paragraph as an argument. It depends on the style of the writer. The two examples here given in the two slides, one the points, lecturing as a method of teaching, the points are given, and the next slide it reflects the continuous paragraph. So it depends again, I would say, that the style of the writer or the style of the speaker, how he or she provides the details to the readers or to the listeners. Exemplification. It is often useful in definitions to give examples. This action is known as exemplifications or exemplifying. There are different ways of exemplifying. For example, geology may be defined as the science of the earth's history as shown by its crust, rocks, etc., etc. In the same way, geography, in the same way, the various examples, when we want to explain the given situation with the help of examples, then this expository sub-skill is called exemplification. Drawing conclusion often involves making a summary of the main points already made. Finally, at the end, as a conclusion, to come to the conclusion in few words, to sum up last words, these are some of the words or phrases which can be used for the this sub-skill of expository writing skill, drawing conclusion. So now these were a few examples of the writing skills. We classified them into sub-skills. Now, as a conclusion of this lecture, we can say that writing is a skill which can be learned through practice, learning through stages, then various sub-skills, and definitely writing skill. We can say that writing skill is an integral part of language learning, just like the other skills, listening, speaking, and reading. Thank you very much for your kind attention.